So let's look at our definition of fitness and how they all play a role. So I take those four models. The first three are going to play into our definition, which is work capacity, across broad time, and modal domains. That's our definition of fitness. And what the heck does that mean? So work capacity, what you can do, broad time across all different time domains, short, medium, long, and also broad domains, all the different things that you could possibly do. Can you run? Can you punch? Can you jump? How far? How fast? That we can measure it. That makes sense to you guys? And we can graphically represent that. So I have time here, power. I'm going to take all those activities and plot them on this graph, okay, for one person. So this is one individual. So our high power activities, so Dom talked about the 100 meter sprint, right? That was 10 seconds or less than 10 seconds if you're Usain Bolt. So that's up here. So very short, high power. I could plot out Fran. Maybe the 5 minute mark for really fast ones. I can put in a 20 minute workout. Cindy, I could put in that 5K down here. And I could plot many different activities on this graph. That makes sense to you guys? And there's gonna be some overlap. So I have the 100 meter sprint here. I might also have a one rep max deadlift. What I'm looking for is the average in all of those spots, and there I can graph out your fitness. Yeah, so this is your work capacity right here, guys. That's what you actually did that we measured and we can plot. Okay, you with me? Yes, goes Jenn, yes. So if this represents your work capacity, what you can do, how do those models tie in? So our work capacity, that's our power equation, right? Our force times distance that Chuck talked about over time. That's what we're measuring. Our time, we get that from Model 2. Remember, that was the metabolic pathways that I talked about. And then our modal domains, that's going to be model number 1 and 3. So we had the adaptations, those 10 general physical skills, my power, speed, and everything on the 1,000 meter row, if I'm developed in that cardiorespiratory endurance, stamina, and balance across all those things. So you with me? So we measure that. So then that leads me to what I put up here in the beginning. What's our goal with this? So this is like my logbook, right? This is everything that I could do today. What is my goal with this curve? What do you guys think? Do I just want to stay here chilling? This is my work capacity? I want to go up, yeah. Like Cardi B, up, is it up, is it up, right? I don't know if that's what she meant, but all right, we want to go up, all right? I told you I was corny. All right, so we want to raise the area under the curve up. So I want to raise up my data points, right? Did I get fitter? Yes. So our goal is to increase. That work capacity across broad time and modal domains. Now, I'm gonna ask y'all another question, see if you were with me the whole time. You ready, Carson? All right. So that means how much of any one thing do I need? So if my goal is to raise up the whole end of the curve, right? You with me? Do I need to get stronger? Wayne says not really. I kind of like that answer, not really. Okay, do I need to get faster? You said no, you say yes, Chloe. Well, it depends, right? I need to get stronger or faster only in relation to how it raises up the total curve, right? So if we think about mountain guy, remember mountain, our deadlifter? His power curve, he's really strong, right? May start out really high and then phew. Does he have a lot of area under that curve? No. So if I get stronger, that may drop down part of my curve. That makes sense? And then if I want to be like Kipchoge, I'm just going to start running all the time. I'm never going to get a sub two-hour mile. That's not happening. But his curve may look something like this. Starts out low and he just kind of like hangs out there. Does that make sense? So he doesn't have a lot of area either. So the reason I liked Wayne's response is not really, it all depends. So that's why it's important to work on your weaknesses, right? Because that's going to raise up our total area under the curve. Great. Go for it. So how much? Only as much as we need to raise that total area. Questions on that, guys? We're good? You following that?